Hey guys, welcome to Crack JKSSB. Today we are going to share a special video with you regarding the cheat codes in MCQs, in solving MCQs. This is presented to you by Gauhar Iqbal. These are the cheat codes for solving MCQs in SSB, SSC, PSC, etc. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Cheat codes for solving MCQs. Firstly, the disclaimer is, all the advice given by me in this tutorial is completely personal and are to be adapted only if it suits you. If it does not suit you, please quit. Despite contrary claims, negative marking is a good thing and anyone can exploit it. I do not encourage cheating. Firstly, never go inside the examination hall with a preconceived notion. If the paper is hard, you may not be able to attempt even 5% questions with surety. If the paper is very easy, you may be able to attempt 100% questions. Usually, it is not the question which is hard, but the options make the question hard. Let's have a look at it. Extremely easy question. What is the distance between Earth and Moon? Option A, 10 km, option B, 100 km, option C, 1000 km, option D, 384,400 km. As you can see, you can easily eliminate option A, option B, option C. Because 10 km is too short, 100 is just nothing, C, the option C, 1000 km is just from Delhi to Srinagar or something like that, and anyone can choose 384,400 kilometers. Let's now take a look at an extremely hard question. What is the distance between Earth and Moon? Let's see it from the angle that options make the question hard. Option A, 384,300 kilometers. Option B, 384,400 kilometers. Option C, 384,500 kilometers. And option D, 384,400 kilometers. As you know that the option B is correct, as you saw in the last option, otherwise it would have been quite difficult for you and for any Tom, Dick and Harry, as well as Einstein, to solve this very question. So hence you got the point that options make the question easy or difficult. Let's take a look at another extremely easy question. In which year Akbar was born? Option A, 80 AD. Option B, 180 AD. Option C, 2015. Option D, 1542 AD. You can easily guess that option C can never be the answer because it passed recently. 2015 was recently, just 2 years back. And option A, 80 AD. Then option A and option B, there was no idea about Mughal Empire. We had no, the world had no idea about the Persians. There was no idea about the trade between two countries or something like that. There was no colonialism, etc. And option D is, we are certain that option D is correct. Then you can eliminate option A, B and C. Hence get the option D ultimately as the correct answer. Let's make it a hard question. In which year Akbar was born? Option A, 1540. Option B, 1544 AD. Option C, 1543. Option D, 1542 AD. What I wanted to convey to you by making this extreme hard question is that options make the question hard, not the question is itself hard. By changing the perspective and familiarity index, what JKPSC does that it makes any question hard by changing the options. That's it. Every question can be made hard and vice versa. Let's take a look at an extremely easy question. Who is the Prime Minister of India? Lalit Modi, Narendra Modi, Amit Shah, Manmohan Singh. Modi. Who Modi? Option B, Narendra Modi. Let's take a look at an extremely hard question from this very section. Who is the Prime Minister of South Korea? Option A, Lee Nak-yoon. Yinak Leon, option B, option C, Lee Lak, Yilak Leon, option D, Yu Nak Yon. Unless and until if you correctly know the answer, as well as the sepal, you can't even guess the answer of this very question. That's what I wanted to convey to you, that options make the question hard. The question is not hard itself. Let's see the strategy for 2018 lab stand and teacher strategy. As a lab stand exams are over, you can apply these very you can apply this strategy in teacher post as well. Going by previous attempts, you should attempt at least 85% of the question paper. Lab stand cut for general and RBA in CBT will be 80 plus minus 10 for an average of 30 posters, as the posters are different for every district. As post count is different for every district, adjust for other categories accordingly. Cheating in this video means that even when you don't know the answer, you can mark it correctly using an educated guess and get markers. Remember the word educated guess. Don't think that I am encouraging you to take your phones along to the examination hall and call your friend to know the answer. Even if you are a below average student who has difficulty in memorizing stuff, you can watch this tutorial and can get benefit from it a lot. Now I will be telling you about some tools which have been developed after solving hundreds of thousands of MCQs, which in turn will help in attempting 100% of any question paper. Are you ready? That is the question. Throughout all the preconceived notion and prejudices and biases, sare batate rehte honge, everyone used to tell negative marking, hey, oh my god, there is negative marking, we can't attempt most of the questions, people are attempting only 40 questions, leaving 60 questions out. See, this method will not take you anywhere. You have to take the risk, and especially I'm not biased, humanities people, humanities students face this problem a lot, and they don't attempt much questions because they don't have any background in solving MCQs. While our favorite engineers and doctors, they can solve as many MCQs, and for last 10 years they have been solving lakhs of MCQs, and we know how to use such methods. So for humanities students who are 50% of the competition, rather more, forget anything about negative marking. I personally guarantee you it will help you. So let's get started. Elimination method. Just try to eliminate as many options as you can using your pre-existing knowledge base. Remember, pre-existing knowledge base. If you eliminate one option, you have 33% of chances of getting it right. If you eliminate two options, you have 50% chances of getting it right. If you eliminate all three options, you have 100% chance of getting it right. Just try to eliminate one option at least, and then attempt it at any cost. Does it help? Let's see. Assume you don't know answer to all the questions. If you don't attempt any one, you will get zero. If you attempt all 100, if we apply probability, and if you can eliminate zero option, you will get zero net correct. If you can eliminate any one option, you will get 10.67 net correct. If you can eliminate any two options, you will get 33.67 net correct. If you can eliminate any three options, you will get 100% net correct. Elimination method. So how to use this elimination method? Question. In which year Akbar was born? Option A, 80 AD. Option B, 180 AD. Option C, 2015 AD. Option D, 1542 AD. It cannot be 80 AD, it cannot be 180 AD, it cannot be 2015 because it recently passed, and for sure it must be 1542. Just remember that PEK is the key, pre-existing knowledge is the key. Use it to eliminate it. Pre-existing knowledge base is the key. Use it to eliminate it. Use it or lose it. Now, in which century Akbar was born? It is slightly trickier. Now, let's look at the options. Option A, 14th century. Option B, 15th century. Option C, 16th century. Option D, 17th century. Now, if you remember any fact about the Mughal dynasty, then you should be able to eliminate some of the options. Like Mughals came to India in 16th century. Then option B and option A can never be wrong. Hence, by this assumption, either option C or option D is correct. Even without knowing the correct answer, you can eliminate two options easily and can be 50% sure. Now, I will show you another type of elimination method. In which biome there is high rainfall and high temperature throughout the year with abundant biodiversity? Whether you know anything about biodiversity or not, it doesn't matter, but you should know about the high rainfall and high temperature. Therefore, you can conclude that A, tundra, and B, taiga can't be the answers. Hence, you conclude that option A and option B can never be right. Therefore, you are eliminating option A as well as option B. Even without knowing the correct answer, you can eliminate two options and be 50% sure. It is absolutely simple. There is no rocket science behind it. People are not aware about it, actually. Now, in which biome there is high rainfall and high temperature throughout the year with abundant biodiversity? Option A, tundra, tropical, deciduous, temperate forest, or temperate deciduous. Option A, tundra cannot be the answer because tundra has permafrost, permanently frozen soil. So how can there be high temperature? That too, throughout the year. Whether you are confused in the next three options, that doesn't matter. But at least you can eliminate option A. Even without knowing the correct answer, you can eliminate one option and can be 33% sure. Now, another type of question. Let's see it. Match the following. Ganges, Egypt. Lake Michigan, USA. Lake Baikal, Russia. Nile, India. Let's assume that you have never heard the Lake Michigan, Lake Baikal, or Nile. Absolutely never heard, but you know that Ganges is in India. So answer of one has to be four. Let's see the options. So accordingly, 1 cannot be matched with 2 because the answer of 1 has to be 4 at any cost. So option A is wrong. Option B. Again, 1 cannot be matched with 2, so option B is wrong. Let's see option C. And everybody knows that Nile is in Egypt. Hence, the answer of option number 4, Nile, must be 1. But as you see here, that the JKPSC will struck you with these like options. The point here is that even with knowing one fact, that is Ganges is in India, you can eliminate almost two options. You can eliminate two options over here. That's how geniuses work. They work in scarcity. There is no abundance of knowledge. In general knowledge, there can never be abundance of knowledge. You have to understand it. Anyway, I will tell you one more last example of questions which are encountered in the exam. Which of the following is correct? India has 10% of the world's largest geographical area. India has 17% of the world's population. There is no one who has won Nobel Prize in chemistry twice. These are the type of questions which hurt us the most. They gave us headache and heartache. Heartache later. First they gave us headache in the exam hall when we are unable to solve them, and heartache later when we are unable to make it to the list. Let's assume that you know India has 2.4% of world's geographical area. assume that you know option 1 is incorrect, because it says that India has 10% of world's largest geographical area. Sentence second, India has 17% of world's population. Let's assume you know nothing about it. And option 3, there is no one who has won Nobel Prize in chemistry twice. Let's also assume that you know nothing about it, unless you know Frederick Sanger, who worked on insulin, who won Nobel Prize twice. Therefore, according to you, option 1 is wrong, because you know India has 2.4% of world's largest geographical area. Hence, option A is incorrect at any cost. Option B, leave it here. Option C contains option 1, because it says India has 10% of world's geographical area. Hence, option A and option C are both wrong. Therefore, you conclude that option B or D can be the answer. Because as you know, India has 17% of world's population, you can be sure. Hence, mark it as correct. Because even if you divide 1.2 divided by 7, that will give you almost or approximately 17% of the world's population, which is presently living in India. As I told you that option 3 is incorrect. There is no one. There is a person, Frederick Sanger, who has won Nobel Prize in chemistry twice. Therefore, option B, 2 only, is the correct answer. Interestingly, this question is teaching us another fact, which I am quoting from a meta-study. Meta-study means study of studies. Normally, as we see, the probability or the percentage of a question, of an option being correct is 25%. A option, B option, C option, D option. That means 100 divided by 4 is equal to 25%. But when an option is none of the above, the meta-studies have shown that it has just 21% probability that it can be right. So from here onwards, remember that none of the above option has less chances of being right. So even if you don't know any of the options, please do not choose none of the above as the correct answer, because it is less likely to be the correct answer. These are the cheats. This is the second cheat which I am telling you. None of the above is usually not the answer. Let's take a look at assertion reason type questions. Assertion A. Assertion. tRNA plays a key role in protein formation. Reason. India has around 7500 km coastline. This is the last type of question for today. Let's see the options. Here, as you know, India has around 7500 km coastline. It's right. So option 4, both are false, is eliminated. And reason is false is eliminated. Option 3 and option 4, both are eliminated. As two options are eliminated, you 100% know that this reason cannot be the reason of the above assertion, because tRNA has no links with the Indian coastline. So reason is absolutely not the correct explanation of A. So option A is explained, hence answer is B. This is the technique of doing these very questions. Did you see the beauty of this very question? You had no idea about the assertion, yet you concluded the correct answer. That is option number 2. Let me give you some final tips to you. If you cannot eliminate any option, remember, if you cannot eliminate any option, then do not attempt it unless you attempted only 20 to 30 questions. If you have only done 20 to 30 questions and come out of the examination hall, then you should forget about your selection. Tip number 2. Do not be afraid of the negative marking. Please, it's my humble request. Jo aata hai utna karke aa jana. This is wrong. This is absolutely wrong. If you do only what you know, then there are almost no chance of you getting selected. They are all kinds of illogical rules. Please don't follow them. Please don't apply these illogicals on your exam. And now, these are the last two. These are the last two tips. Chances of answer being all of the above is approximately 34%. Unless you know that all of the above is not right, if you have to just choose the answer as you have done as you have attempted less number of questions, then choose all of the above answer if there is one. Chances of answer being none of the above is 21%, just 21%. Remember it. This is the last and the third cheat code for today. First is elimination method. Second is none of the above. And finally, the last cheat code is, if there are absolute terms like always, never, 100%, 0%, which are taking the statement to extreme, it is less likely to be correct. Like there is absolute population of Muslims in Lakshadweep. That's wrong. There are just 93% Muslims in Lakshadweep. It is less likely to be correct, especially in the social sciences, because in social sciences, absolute or extremes are less likely to be possible. Similarly, if there are terms like maybe, may not be, can be, rarely, and most of the times, more often than not, shall be, etc., which avoid the extreme and talk about the related terms, then it has high chance of being correct. Remember, it has high chance of being correct, especially in social sciences. Please try to concentrate hard on the mental image of books, classes, and blogs, and my videos, and try to eliminate at least one option. Please do not close your eyes and sit here. Is saal nahi ho payega. Read question carefully twice and focus on keywords like correct, true, or false, incorrect. Read question twice. I repeat, read question twice. People think that they have been asked correct, but what they have been asked is not correct. Not correct. So please focus on the keywords in the question like correct, true, or false, or incorrect. Now the next tip goes like this. Finally, do not waste time on questions about which you have no clue. Please do not have ego conflict inside the hall because all questions carry equal marks. Please don't waste time on questions about which you have almost no clue. So let's hope it helps. It was just a small and humble method of solving MCQs. I know I will get a lot of crap from you from your side in the comment section or somewhere else. There are lots of haters out there. I know it won't go well under your thoughts. But what matters is it was just a humble attempt for me from my side to help you. It doesn't matter to me. If I can just help 10 to 15 persons out there who can qualify, that is what matters. I will be more than happy if the efforts will be successful. Best of luck, everybody. Anyway, if you think that it could help you in your recently in the next coming exams, then please don't forget to subscribe to the channel for latest updates.